All right, hello and good evening, or good morning, or good afternoon, wherever you may be. You have to forgive me, I do have a slight cold, but I still wanted to make a video and go over painting. I have seen some pretty positive and instructive videos on YouTube. You have Dr. Faust, who does an amazing job. Big shout out to him. But overall, as far as, you know, you can get as far into it as you want to go with art theory and color and palette, and but miniature painting should be easy. It should be simplistic. It should not be this giant mystery. For example, I just want to touch up on this guy. He's, my daughter calls him the broccoli monster, and he's a little druid familiar that is a tree. And pretty simple. There's not going to be a lot of detail to it. You can choose what color palette you want. The main point is when you're going from something simple that is, you know, this will probably have, you know, a green and brown and black, and then a wide array of, you know, lights and darks within that color choice, to something like this guy, who is one of my favorites. He just is a great well-made model by Reaper Bones. This was still just as simple. It's just more colors. The painting style that you want to focus on, if you really want to get into this, and let me show you one that I'm actually working on right now, and you'll have to excuse it. She is a little cross-eyed, if you can see. But when you're looking at painting a figure that is fairly complex, and you want to still put detail in there that it reads proper, it doesn't look like it came out of a paint factory floor, just a jumbled mess, as you paint from the back to the front. And like I said, this one is a little cross-eyed, and if you notice here in her pupils, I started with the green. It starts with the primer first, which is the white that you see on this. This is a pewter figure. Again, a Reaper's Mini. But I started with the primer, so that gives the white to her eye, which is here in the corner. I then went to the green and then went to the black. And what you will see online, as far as YouTube, they teach a different method where they go from the darkest color and then they build layers on top of that. Which is kind of a reverse to any kind of artistic painting. You usually start with light and go to dark. You can do it both ways, but the method that I prefer of going from light to dark gives you more variables. There's more options that you can do. For example, and I'm going to move away from this gal and move over to him, is this was a quick paint that I did. You can see it on my Instagram page of Manifest Nerdery. And this is an example of what I was talking about, where I built the layers, and so you get a more richer tone. And this is just using game color paints. I do use oils from time to time, because I think it gives a richer tone to the minis. But overall, this is going building layers from light to dark using washes and just understanding how color stacks. I did want to give him a nice glow on the shoulders, as if the flames that he was conjuring were reading onto him. It gives it a more believable color palette, and where you buy that this guy, okay, he's casting, conjuring flames. But overall, it's just a building of colors. And again, this is simple. All I have here is green, red, brown, blue, gold. And then washes of black, some skin tone. And again, please excuse me, I do have a terrible cold right now. Pardon me. But overall, it's not a lot of color. It's just placing it in the right spot. So from there, now that I've kind of laid a mini foundation of what I'm going to try and go over with you guys, hopefully that you can gain something from this, as now we'll take a look at actually putting and laying down some paint. You'll have to excuse my color palette. It is I like to use, like you see a lot of people use foil. This is actually just a cutting mat. It works really well. I like that it is so colorful. The downside to doing this, I will warn you ahead of time, is that when you get this much on here, you will lose the paint that you've put down. And if you're anything like me, you will spend several minutes trying to find the actual wet paint that you are using. And one other thing that I just want to go over is, if you notice my water dish, I like to use a short water dish. This breaks the habit of setting a paintbrush brush bristles down and letting it sit there. And the downside to doing that is, if you're invested in your paintbrushes, you're going to destroy them pretty quick when you put them in a tall jar of water, because the bristles will bend like this. And over time, you'll find that they will flare out, as you can kind of see that this guy's done. I don't know if you can pick that up or not, but this guy, I like this brush. It's not an expensive brush. It's just my kind of spread paint and slop it on their brush. But use a short water can. The most you can do is that, but you get a paintbrush in there, it's gonna start falling out. It just breaks you of that habit. And I'm a huge advocate for starting good habits before and not having to break bad ones. So, as we'll see, we've got a little broccoli guy. I've actually not prepared for this at all. Like I said, sickness, and I got what I like to call medicine head. Again, starting with lights to darks, I'm going to start with a little game color, Livery Green, or Verde Belice, if you speak Spanish, which I absolutely do not. I will say that the voices in my head do speak Spanish, but that's how I know I'm not crazy, is that I do not speak Spanish, so we're on non-communicable terms right now. So I just want to put down a nice, and again, building layers, please, if I can emphasize anything, build layers. If you want to get something to where you're just playing, maybe you're playing Dungeons & Dragons or what have you, and you want to get a figure for the evening, or you came up with some brilliant trap to kill all your friends, and you need that figure tonight, then just throw some paint on. You can always go over it again, as long as you don't seal it. But even then, there's ways around that. But again, I'm just getting paint on. Like I said, this is just my paint spreader. Might as well be a spray can. But just get it on there, nice and thin. I like to work in thin layers, as you can see. I mean, this is really light. I don't know if that color is reading on this camera. But, pardon me, we'll just build layers up, and hopefully we'll get some likes. This will be my first YouTube video, and I'm kind of new to it, and I'm actually very new to figure painting. I am a quote-unquote trained artist, but this is new to me. I've always been a painter, but what got me into minis was actually my kids. They are nerds, for lack of a better term, but nerd is not a bad word in our house. So they really like the storytelling aspects of Dungeons & Dragons and like the character creation, and so the theater of the mind that you usually play Dungeons & Dragons in, they had some trouble understanding that, so we moved on to figurines. And I took on and painting them so that they could have nice figures to play with, and it's become quite a relaxing hobby for myself, so I do enjoy it. And please excuse me while I'm digging through and looking for the right color that I want. And you're gonna have to excuse how many times I've said excuse me. I'm already noticing that I'm begging for many pardons already. But why not be polite from the get-go? So, and here for the brown, I'm just throwing on some khaki from Game Color. I do like Game Color inks. I haven't used the Citadel. I actually have no opinion on either one. Like I said, I haven't used it. Not for any particular reason other than the local hobby store that I do buy my paints at does not have Citadel. They only carry Game Color. So I'm interested. I do want to say that. I am interested in trying their paints. But so far I have found that Game Color is really good paint. Now it's what I'm doing here, you can see, so this guy, he has these recesses where his eyes and his mouth are, so paint will pool into there. The medium of the, not the pigment, but the medium that actually holds the pigment is not water, it's some sort of chemical, and I'm sure someone out there that's much smarter than I am can tell you what that is, but I digress. The paint will pool inside of there, and if you don't take your brush, now my brush is not wet with paint anymore. I've already spread enough paint around that it's kind of come off the brush, so now I can go back in and just dab and pull that paint out. So this pigment's going to stay in there, but it's not pooling anymore. Do yourself a favor. If you do have very fine detail that's in a recess like that, do yourself a favor and pull it out. Otherwise, you're going to spend forever trying to dig that paint out. Or what usually happens is a person will get some paint in there and they realize that they've lost that minute detail that that recess provided, and they try to fake it. They'll just try to paint it on, literally just conjure something from their mind and doodle onto the surface. So try to stay away from that. But again, just light layers, very thin paint. Let me see if I adjust the lighting, maybe you can see that a little better. So he's a light brown, again, khaki and livery green. So we're just gonna build from here and just keep going. I'll have to edit this video down a little bit because it's already getting lengthy. So, and you'll probably be able to tell my background music will jump around. Maybe I'll put a fast forward on here too, although I am narrating quite a bit. But hopefully this will kind of help some people out there that are maybe struggling with painting minis, or maybe they're looking to get into minis. And again, the way I figured this out, again, I was already had some idea of how to paint and had painted and taught art classes. But what really helped me again was Mr. Faust's painting clinic on YouTube. And he gave me sort of the structural blueprints of what goes into painting a miniature and how to do that. But from there, I applied my own style of painting and what actually works for me. And you know, maybe my style doesn't work for you. Maybe you like going dark to light. And just make sure I got some good coverage. And I'm going to let this guy dry. As you see, you got him pretty well covered. He looks like the broccoli monster, like my daughter likes to call him. We're actually running the Tyranny of Dragons campaign right now for Dungeons & Dragons. And one of the creatures I've discovered, again, I'm new to Dungeons & Dragons, like I said, is twig blights, little tree bush sort of creatures, and there's a ton of them. So I'm hoping I can actually get a bunch of these guys and use them as my twig blights and my 3D gaming. But so yeah, we're gonna stop here, and I will, once this paint dries, I'll come back to it and we'll go over some more stuff. I'm sure I'll think of some more things to sit and babble to you guys about, but hopefully this will be a good intro. Take care.